I want to see the Alliance map. What transpires in Gloucestershire?
You may have noticed that Gunnar has disappeared from his forge. He has traveled to Gloucestershire in search of a wife.
A wife?
He is in love.
When did this happen?
When doesn't this happen with our dear, lovelorn blacksmith? But there is a bright side. He has asked you to join him.
Join his search for a wife?
And see that he does not make a fool of himself. I believe he thinks that your presence would bolster his image.
All right, I'll be Gunnar's keeper, if only to bring him back in one piece.
Very generous of you. Make for the town of Gloucester. You will find him there.
Morgun okkar frækinn!
We're off!
Let the sail out!
I've lost my key!
This is your house.
I set my key down, only to watch it fall into the river. My name's Bronn.
Hi, Bronn.
Ah, a Dane. I have an object inside that you'd be interested in. Legendary horn of Ragnar Lothbrok.
You have Ragnar's horn? How can you know it was his?
You have me there, friend. I cannot be certain. It's a very old Dane horn. Help me into my house. You can judge for yourself.
I'm curious to see this horn.
I hid it somewhere long ago. Forgive me, I can't recall just where. Help me search.
Hello.
done, friend. Ah, look at that.
That's no horn.
Hmm. Let me have a look.
Hold! Thief! You filthy Dane, get out of my house!
This man told me this house was his.
Have you any idea how important I am? I shall have you both flayed and hung from the city gates.
Friend, it's all a simple misunderstanding.
If you were deceived, Dane, you'll return my Biblo and help me kill this villain.
Bronn is my friend. I will defend him to your death.
Oh, bless you, Dane!
Prepare to die, piles of horse droppings!
So what was this all about?
He bragged about that object all over the village. Keep it, friend. You deserve it.
I regret only that I did not hear the battle song of Ragnar's horn.
I spoke with him again. He said that he pined, and I feel torn in two. My loyalty to him tears me one direction, and the Nephilim point elsewhere. Why hath these voices spoken to me? The gospels sing within me, and yet I sense conflict. I sense disagreement among the angels. It saddens me greatly. I will one day weigh my soul, attempt penance, attempt to repent for the missteps in my life. Yet here, called.
There's a force here. Invisible.
Finnum dýrgripar.
Show me.
For the dock.
Hold on.
The Quickhelm was the best that I know.
This place is heavily guarded.
Oswald's tunic.
Meum est sordidum planetum revolutam, sed non non. Ubilutam est.
Get back! Now!
Keep your eyes open.
Oh, Starlight! My Starlight! A swift death by a sharp sting separates us, both by lip and by heart.
Whether by land or by sea, we never shall part.
A fellow romantic soul! Perhaps you might be able to aid my plight.
What ails you?
A witch told me that one sting from the fuzzy little demon would steal my breath. But my love keeps bees.
You cannot deliver your love letter because there are bees in the way. I could carry it for you.
If you would do this kindness for Gil, then you must be a kindred spirit. Do you also enjoy the stamen and the petal?
I enjoy much of many things.
Oh, I had a feeling you would understand. I have painted my love in words in this letter. Let your romantic heart guide you.
If I find this love of yours, I'll deliver your feelings. I'm sure your words will lead me to your heart's desire.
Thank you! Oh, thank you, stranger! I shall call you Sunshine, for you broke through the clouds of my loneliness.
The sweetness of honey on the tongue, with the danger of being stung. It is like love, always a chance of losing.
Oh, Starlight! My Starlight! A swift death by a sharp have you
It's a man and not more. It's been done. No. It's
Show me what lies ahead.
Yeah.
of these keepers of the bees fits Gil's poems. Would you say that you are cow-eyed and willow-limbed?
Oh, I suppose. I'm not sure what that means, but it is pretty.
My mistake. Do you consider yourself a man who has features so delicate that God himself must have painted them on with a fine brush?
Yes.
Forgive my intrusion. Would you say that your hair could be described as bracken-colored tresses?
I beg your pardon?
It met. Hello again.
The wandering poet!
Not me, but an admirer who prefers to remain secret until you two can meet. I have a letter with more details.
Oh, goodness! Many thanks! I cannot wait to meet my admirer!
I have delivered the letter. Now to see if Gil has met his match. Which of these keep? Would you say that your hair could be described as bracken-colored tresses?
I beg your pardon?
An admirer of yours asked.
I know these words. I've kept the brothers of this letter beneath my pillow. To finally meet my secret bard. I must go.
I have delivered the letter. Now to see if Gil has met his match.
I have kept your letters under my pillow to give me dreams as sweet as your words. Now I know my love is sweet as apples.
My starlight! It's as if my heart is to burst with this happiness. My love requited.
Now, tell me more of my lashes and how they are like for...
Your lashes? Why, they are beautiful. But they are a candle in the brilliance of your hands. So warm and strong in mine.
Good for you, Gil. Best of luck to you both.
No, use that stone, Eivor. Use the large one, there.
Do you like the snow, Sigurd?
I suppose. I accept it.
I love it. I wish it could gather under my skin, surround my bones, and cloak me in silence. Just the way it quiets the land.
Snow like arrows? The scald in you speaks. I admit it does calm me down some.
If everyone sat and watched the soft, chunky snow fall and said nothing, nothing at all, we would all be happier.
Snow makes for a poor plowing bed. That's what I know.